So yesterday we were doing Happy Prince, this chapter. We have read first and second and third page. So up to that we have come to know that we were reading that part. That Happy Prince statue, it was situated on a raised platform high up in the air. Okay. So when he saw, he was able to see the whole view of the city. So when he saw that there was one lady in a cottage, okay, and that lady, she was busy in stitching gown for one of the princes. So because of that stitching, she got so many marks on her hands. Her condition was so poor, she was so poor that she was not able to afford food and anything for her ailing son. Her son was ill, he was lying on the bed. And to see such kind of condition, Happy Prince had tears in his eyes, and these tears fell on Swallow. So when Swallow experienced this thing, he was so strange that there is no cloud in the sky. So from where these drops are coming? Because even statue started crying. It was so amazing thing that statue started crying because to see that he was so moved to see the condition of that house. So after that, Happy Prince thought that he should do something for that lady. So he requested Swallow that there is a ruby in his sword, and he told him that you pick up that ruby from my store, from my sword, and you give that ruby to, ruby is a very precious stone, it is very much expensive, that you give it to that lady, and this lady would be taking this and she would be able to sell it into the market, and she will have a plenty of money to survive a better life. So up to that we have gone through, okay, we have gone through page number 29. So what was the response of Swallow? Swallow said that his friends are flying up and they have gone to another place, okay, and he is waiting there for them in Egypt. So you read, Simran, you read this page number 30. Yes, Simran, start reading.
Yes, ma'am. I am waited for in Egypt, said the swallow. My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to the large lotus flowers. Soon they will go to sleep. The prince asked the swallow to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. The boy is so thirsty and the mother so sad, he said. I don't think I like boys, answered the swallow. I want to go to Egypt. But the happy prince looked so sad that the little swallow was sorry. It is very cold here, he said, but he agreed to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. Thank you, little swallow, said the prince. The swallow picked out the green ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. He passed by the cathedral tower where the white marble angels were sculptured. He passed by the palace and heard the sound of dancing. A beautiful girl came out on the balcony with her lover. I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball, she said. I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstresses are so lazy. He passed over the river and saw the lanterns hanging on the masts of the ship. At last, he came to the poor woman's house and looked in. The boy was tossing feverishly on his bed, and the mother had fallen asleep. She was so tired. In he hopped and laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble. Then he flew gently around the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. How cool I feel, said the boy. I must be getting better. And he sank into a delicious slumber. Then the swallow flew back to the happy prince and told him what he had done. It is curious, he remarked, but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold. That is because you have done a good action, said the prince. And the little swallow began to think and then fell asleep. Thinking always made him sleepy.
Okay, now in this page, what we have come to know, Swallow told about his, now my voice is audible. Tell me, yesterday a strange thing happened. I was so surprised. I was so engrossed in teaching you. I couldn't read your messages. voice is audible? Okay. In between, I will be asking you because there is a problem in that wire. It will be repaired very soon today. So when Swallow told about this thing that his friends had gone to another place, okay, and talking to large lotus flowers, soon they will go to sleep. So such kind of thing was told by when Swallow, but there was a one request that was made by Prince. What request was made by Prince? Prince made that request, please stay with me for one night and you just act as my messenger, okay? Because he told that you just go and see in that cottage that the condition of the boy is very poor. The boy is feeling so thirsty and the mother is so sad to see her ailing son. So answer, what was the response of Swallow? That I don't think that I like boys. So Swallow was not moved. Swallow was not moved to listen about their story. Okay, and he said, no, no, I wanted to go to Egypt because I wanted to go to my friends because I alone has left there. Okay, and my all friends have gone there. So I want to go to my friends. But Happy Prince, he was looking so sad and little Swallow, he was feeling so sorry. So he said that it is so cold here. So at last he agreed that, okay, he would stay with him for one night only and he would act like his messenger. How messenger? Because he wanted to send something to that poor lady. So little Swallow said, Prince said, okay, thank you, little Swallow. So Swallow, he picked up that great ruby from Prince Ford, okay, and he kept that ruby in his beak, okay, and he flew over the roofs of the town. Okay, so when he was flying there, so he passed by the cathedral tower. Cathedral tower, it is just like a main church. So he passed main church also. You write down this meaning on your books. Where the white marbles angels were sculpted. What is the meaning of sculpted? It means, suppose there are some tombs and buildings. Something is written, some images are carved out, okay? So these were made, or you can say carved out. Sculptured, okay? So what happened? Where white marble angels, they were sculptured, okay, they were made, they were carved out, okay, and he passed by the palace and there he got a chance to listen the sound of dancing. So who was dancing there? There was a very beautiful girl, okay, she was dancing there. She came out of the balcony with her lover. And who was that girl? Whose gown, whose dress was being stitched by that seamstress, that female tailor who was stitching one of the dress, and whose dress she was stitching of that beautiful girl. And she was expecting that her dress would be ready in the time for the state ball. State ball is a, you can say, dance party, okay? So she told that she has given order that flowers should be, that embroidery of flowers should be done on that, okay? But this seamstress, she is so lazy, she is not able to design my dress on time. So this was a mentality of that princess, but seamstress, she was doing a lot of hard work. Even her son was not well, still she was doing her work. Okay, so now the swallow journey is being described here. The swallow was passing over the river. Okay, he saw that there were lanterns, okay, which were hanging on the ships. After passing through all the, you can say, passages, finally swallow came in poor woman's house and he started looking inside. Okay, so the boy was tossing feverishly. Tossing means, what is the meaning of tossing? Yes, tossing means moving. He was not able to sleep properly because of high fever. So he was just moving on his bed. He was feeling so. He was so sick. He was not able to sleep properly. So that's why he was tossing on his bed. It means he was moving on his bed. And the mother went to sleep. Why so? Because she was dead tired. After doing a lot of hard work, she was feeling dead tired and she went to sleep. Okay. In he hopped and laid the great ruby on the table. He hopped means he jumped. So swallow jumped inside. Write down the meaning of hopped. Hopped means jumped. So he jumped inside. Okay, and he kept that great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble. What is the meaning of thimble? Thimble means cap worn on finger for protection. Write down the meaning of thimble. Yes. Thimble is a cap worn on fingers. It protects our finger. Sometimes when we get any injury or when these people, when they do such kind of stitching work, so they get marks on their finger. So what do they wear? They wear thimble. Okay. And after that, swallow flew very gently round the bed and fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. Fanning means, what is the meaning of fanning here? What is the meaning of fanning? Giving air. As we feel so much heat, we start doing like this. So this activity is known as fanning. So giving air. So that swallow gave air to the boy's forehead with his wings. Okay. So boy said, how cool I feel, because he was getting, you can say, cool air because of its wings. And he said, now I'm feeling so cool and I would be getting better. Okay. And he sank into a delicious slumber. What is the meaning of delicious slumber? Here, delicious is not a dish. It is not like tasty. But he was feeling, you can say, utterly helpless. He was not able to sleep because of fever, because of heat, because of hunger, okay? Because of less care of his mother also. It feels with us, na, that when we feel, when you people feel sick, what do you require? You require sound sleep. You require love of your parents. Your mother should sit beside you. Isn't it? Then you recover very soon. Okay, medicine should be given to you, proper food, you can say light food should be provided to you. So such kind of things is expected by everyone, whether rich or whether poor. So that boy, he was not able to sleep properly because of high fever, because of that heat also. So when that cool air was given by a swallow, okay, so he thought in his mind, now it is so cool. And in this way, he went into delicious slumber. Slumber means deep sleep. So write down the meaning of slumber. Slumber means sleep. Slumber means sleep. So after that, he went into delicious slumber. It means he went to sleep. I just show you the board so that you can jot down all the meanings. Write down all the meanings. So here delicious is not a dish. Delicious here means peaceful sleep, sound sleep. Okay, so here write down delicious means sound sleep. So boy went into sound sleep, okay, and swallow went back to happy prince, and whatever he had done in their hut, in their cottage, he told each and everything to prince. Okay, so he was so curious to know, but I feel quite warm now. But happy prince said, now after listening to you that you have helped them, you have provided them ruby, you have given them air. Okay, so whatever the activity you have done, and now the boy has gone to sound sleep, after listening to this thing, I am feeling so warm, but still it is too cool. Why he was feeling so warm in that cool weather? What was the reason? Tell me. Because now he was feeling pacified, because he had helped that person. It happens with us, na? When we help anyone, we feel peaceful inside, isn't it? So happy prince, he was so tensed, he was so worried for that family, for that lady and her son. So after helping them, after listening to the story from Swallow, that yes, Swallow had helped them in a right sense. Okay, he had provided them ruby. Okay, now they have gone to sleep soundly. So after that, he was feeling so peaceful. That's why he said that now I'm feeling warm in that cold weather. Clear? Now, prince said that why are you feeling so warm in this cold weather? Because you have done a good action. Whatever the task which was assigned to you, you have done a good action. That's why it is you are feeling so warm. Okay, now little Swallow started thinking about, and after thinking, he just went to sound sleep. Okay, because it happens with us also. When we want to sleep, we are not able to sleep. If we start thinking something, we feel so sleepy very soon. So like that. Now afterwards, Dhiren, you read.
Yes, ma'am. When day broke, he flew down to the river and had a bath. Tonight I go to the Egypt, said the sparrow, and he was high in the spirit at the prospect. He visited all the monuments and sat a long time on the top of the church steeple. When the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. Have you any commission for Egypt? He cried. I am just starting. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Will you stay with me one more night longer? I am waited for in Egypt, answered the swallow. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Far away across the city, I see a young man in a garret. He is leaning over a desk covered with papers, and in the glass by his side, there is a bunch of withered violets. His hair is brown and crisp, and his lips are red as pomegranate, and he has large and dreamy eyes. He is trying to finish a play for the director of the theater, but he is too cold to write anymore. There is no fire in the grate, and the hunger has made him faint. I will wait with you one night longer, said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. Alas, I have no ruby now, said the prince. My eyes are all that I have left. They are made of rare sapphires, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago. He ordered the swallow to pluck out one of them and take it to the playwright. He will sell it to the dweller and buy firewood and finish his play, he said. Dear prince, said the swallow, I cannot do that. And he began to weep. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So the swallow plucked out the prince's eyes and flew away to the young man's garret. It was easy enough to get in, as there was a hole in the roof. Through this he darted and came into the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wings. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on his withered violets. I am beginning to be appreciated, he cried. This is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play. And he looked quite happy. The next day, the swallow flew down to the harbor. He sat on the mast of the large vessel and watched the sailors working. I am going to Egypt, cried the swallow. But nobody minded, and when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. I have come to bid you goodbye, he cried. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Will you not stay with me one more night longer? It is winter, answered the swallow, and the snow will soon be here. In Egypt, the sun is warm on the green palm trees, and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazily about them. In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. She has let her matches fall in the gutter and they are all spoiled. My father will beat her if she does not bring home some money. And she is crying. She has no shoes or stockings and her little head is bare. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her, and her father will not beat her. I will stay with you one more night longer, said the swallow, but I cannot pluck out your eye. You will be quite blind then. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So he plucked out the prince's other eye and darted down with it. He swooped past the match girl and slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. What a lovely bit of glass, cried the little girl, and she ran home laughing. Then the swallow came back to the prince. And you are blind now, he said, so I will stay with you always. No, I will stay with you always.
Wait. Now, what happened afterwards? After that, fellow said that yes, now he wanted to go to Egypt to meet his all friends, because his all friends have already moved and he only is left there. Okay, so he, you can say, planned to go there. To just maintain silence in a class, only then I'll be able to teach. Up to that we have done, okay, that he was feeling so warm after helping that person, okay. So after that, next day started, okay, and he went to the river, he took a bath, and now he made up his mind that tonight he was supposed to move to Egypt. So this was the planning of Swallow. So he was in high spirit at the prospectus, because whatever the planning he has done, he was in high spirit. Yes, he wanted to move there. Okay. So he started visiting all the monuments and he was sitting there for a long time on the top of the church steeple. Okay. And when the moon rose, when it was a time of night, he went back to Happy Prince. Okay, so have you any commissions for Egypt? He cried. I'm just starting. Okay, so this was a question which was asked by swallow. Okay. So prince said, swallow, swallow, little swallow, will you stay with me for one more night? So this was a request made by Happy Prince, that can you stay with me for one more night? Okay. So swallow got annoyed. He said, no, I don't want to stay with you because I am being waited by my friends in Egypt. So that's why I want you to move there. But Happy Prince, he started making request. He said, he told another story because he was able to see in everybody's house. Okay. So he told that there is a young man in a garret. Write down the meanings of these difficult words. Write down the meaning of garret. Garret is a small room on roof. Small room on roof. After garret, write down withered violets. Withered violets, dried up blue purple flowers. Dried up blue purple flowers. Then you write down crisp. Crisp means hard. Write down the meaning side by side. Okay. So this was again one request which was made by Happy Prince. Okay. So he said that far away across the city, he is able to see a young man in a garret. Garret is a small room on roof. And that person is sitting on his desk, and his desk is fully covered with papers. He is leaning over that. Why so? And from that glass, he is able to see that there are withered violets. Withered violets means dried up blue, purple colored flowers, which have become dried up. Okay. And the hair of that person, which are of brown color and which are of crisp. Crisp means which are of hard, which have become hard, and his lips, these are as red as the color of pomegranate. Okay. And he has very large, very dreamy eyes. Okay. And he is trying to finish a play. He is basically writing a play, and he is writing this play for the director of the theater, but it is too cold. He is not able to write. Okay. And why so? Because in his place where he is living, in his garret, there is no fire. So that's why he is feeling so cool. He is not able to complete his play. And because of the hunger also, that person has fainted. Because of hunger, because of cold, that person is not able to complete his task on time, and that person has fainted. Okay. So Swallow said, okay, I will wait with you one more night. Okay. So he told him that you just take another ruby to the young playwright. But Prince said, oh, I don't have ruby now. I was having only one ruby that was in its sword, and that is being given to that family. Okay. Now he said that his eyes are left, and his eyes are also made up of precious stones. So he said that you just pluck one of the stone from one of his eyes and just hand over this sapphire, expensive stone, not ruby, it is, his eyes were made up of eyes. Okay. So that give to playwright, that the writer of that drama. Okay. And he would sell this jewel to jeweler, okay, and he would purchase firewood, okay, and he would be able to finish his play. So Swallow said, no, I am not able to do this. Why so? And he started crying. So he said, no, do whatever I command you. Whatever I command you, whatever the order that I am giving you, you just do. So Swallow, he had to obey him. He plugged one of his stone from one of his eyes and he handed over to that playwright. Because there was a hole in his house. So he easily entered into the house, okay, and through this he darted and came into the room. Write down the meaning of darted. Darted means he just put a stone there and he came to the room, okay. So the young man, he had his head buried in his hand. So he did not hear the flutter of, because his hands were just like that, completely. So that's why he was not able to listen the flutter. Flutter means the sound, flapping sound of his wings. So he was not able to listen the flapping, the sound which is created by wings. He was not able to that the flutter of bird's wings. And when he looked up, he saw that there was a very beautiful stone, okay, which was lying on the withered violets, on the dried up blue purple flowers. Okay, so he said, okay, I'm beginning to be appreciated. He cried, this is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play. So now that writer, he became so happy that this stone is given by some of my admirer. Admirer means you can say one of my fan who reads my plays and he's so impressed. So that's why he has given me. So he became so happy and he started finishing his play. Okay. So the next day, what happened? Now this task was also accomplished. So what was that? So next day he went. Now the bell has gone. We will continue with this chapter tomorrow. Yes.